All right, so before going to the polyarteritis nodosa pen, because it's a vasculitis, it's a variety of vasculitis, means the medium vessel vasculitis, so we need to discuss what are the varieties of vasculitis is available. So let's see, look at the board. So vasculitis is the inflammation of the vessels. So we have the large vessels, we have the medium-sized vessels, we have the small vessels. So large vessel vasculitis, medium vessel vasculitis, and small vessel vasculitis. These three categories of the vasculitis are present. So large vessel vasculitis are giant cell arteritis. Another name of giant cell arteritis is the temporal arteritis. Another large vessel vasculitis is the Takayasu's arteritis. So these two names of the giant and Taka will be helpful to remember. This is the large vessel vasculitis. Giant is large, so we can remember the large vessel vasculitis. Simple questions sometimes come out. Giant cell arteritis is a large vessel vasculitis, medium vessel vasculitis, small vessel, small and medium, medium and small. So what is the answer? The answer will be the large vessel vasculitis. So large word, giant word, it goes all together. So Takayasu's arteritis is another variety of the large vessel vasculitis. Taka is a currency name in Bangladesh. So Taka, definitely the large and giant peoples having that one. So you can remember the Takayasu arteritis is also the large vessel vasculitis. Next point, the medium vessel vasculitis is a pen. Means polyarteritis nodosa. So I have the pen in my hand, you see. So this is the medium-sized pen. If I say I write the medium-sized pen, I write with the medium-sized pen, so we can remember the pen is a medium vessel vasculitis. So another disease, the medium vessel vasculitis is the Kawasaki disease. Kawasaki disease is nothing but the childhood pen. Just write it down within the bracket. Childhood pen. So we can remember the single name, the pen. I write with the medium-sized pen, so it will be helpful for the medium vessel vasculitis, with the pen is the medium vessel vasculitis. Next point, the small vessel vasculitis are divided into the two parts. It is written the ANCA-positive vasculitis and ANCA-negative vasculitis. So ANCA-positive vasculitis are two varieties, like C ANCA, we will discuss, we already discussed in another antibody, autoantibodies and disease associations chapter, the C ANCA diseases. So even then, we are discussing C ANCA is the Wegener's granulomatosis or granulomatous polyangiitis. P ANCA is a disease of microscopic polyangiitis and Schwann-Strauss syndrome. Right? ANCA negative vasculitis that you need to remember. I'm just writing just here. ANCA negative vasculitis. So at least one disease you must remember, that is the Henoch-Schönlein purpura, cryoglobulinemia, and connective tissue disease associated vasculitis. These three diseases that you must remember, the ANCA negative small vessel vasculitis. ANCA negative small vessel vasculitis, once again I'm saying HSP, Henoch-Schönlein purpura. Next is the cryoglobulinemia, as I say, CGN, and next point the connective tissue disease associated vasculitis. So all of these, the vasculitis tends to occur in the variety of the large vessel vasculitis, medium vessel vasculitis, and small vessel vasculitis. So once again, large vessel vasculitis, large, you can remember the giant, the word. Large means the giant, and Takayasu's arteritis. Large vessel vasculitis, giant cell arteritis, and temporal arteritis, and Takayasu's arteritis. Next point, the medium vessel vasculitis, pen, medium-sized pen. So once again, medium vessel vasculitis, the pen, polyarteritis nodosa, and childhood pen is the Kawasaki disease. And small vessel vasculitis are divided into ANCA positive and ANCA negative. ANCA positive vasculitis are C ANCA positive and P ANCA positive. C ANCA positive is the Wegener's granulomatosis, and the name of Wegener's is the granulomatous polyangiitis. And P ANCA positive is the microscopic polyangiitis. And next point is the Schwann-Strauss syndrome. ANCA negative small vessel vasculitis, the three diseases you must remember, that is the HSP, Henoch-Schönlein purpura. Second disease you must remember, cryoglobulinemia. And third disease you must remember, connective tissue disease associated vasculitis. I hope that you understood very, very well what are the vasculitis here. Next point, that our hot topic, that is the polyarteritis nodosa, as we discussed. If I said, what is PEN? PEN is a medium-sized vessel vasculitis. So the diagnostic criteria here and also the features is written, polyarteritis nodosa is vasculitis affecting medium-sized arteries with necrotizing inflammation, leading to aneurysm formation, and PEN is more common in the middle-aged man and is associated with the hepatitis B infection. It is written here, in 1990, the American College of Rheumatology established criteria for research purposes in order to differentiate PEN from other form of vasculitis. A committee of the ACR physicians selected 10 disease features of PEN in order of PEN to be diagnosed. At least 3 of the 10 criteria should be present when radiographic or pathological diagnosis of vasculitis is made. So what are the features? It is written here, weight loss of 4 kg, moricle 4 kg, and then the libido reticularis, testicular pain or tenderness, myalgia, leg weakness, leg tenderness, mononeuropathy, polyneuropathy, diastolic blood pressure greater than 90 mm of mercury, elevated blood urea nitrogen or creatinine level unrelated to dehydration or obstruction, presence of hepatitis B surface antigen or antibody in serum, arteriogram demonstrating aneurysms or occlusions of the visceral arteries, biopsy of the small or medium-sized arteries containing polymorphonuclear neutrophils. So these are the important features of the polyarteritis nodosa. So how can you remember all the features of polyarteritis nodosa? It's really difficult. So before going the full details of the feature, as I always say, that everyone must know the one of the most important core feature that gives the idea of the polyarteritis nodosa or any of the diseases can be diagnosed very easily. The important pathognomonic features, maybe the important feature, maybe the important word, maybe the important sentence that every candidate must know. That is the induction. Alright, so let's see here. So once again, the single word that everybody must remember, PAN, so the single word, one of the most important features, polyarteritis nodosa. So AN will give you the idea, means the aneurysm of aorta. So this is the pathognomonic features that you must remember, that is the PAN, aneurysm of the aorta. PAN, polyarteritis nodosa, AN for aneurysm. Alright, and other features, how can you remember? Let's see now. Now we'll just make it more and more features to be added here. So the PEN SS box, once again, the PEN lost. This PEN lost, the mnemonics will be helpful to remember all the features of PEN. Let's see. So P starts on the PEN, means the pain, we can say, right, the pain, P for pain. Pain means testicular pain or tenderness. Next, P stands on the pain once again, means the myalgia, means the muscle pain, or leg weakness, or leg tenderness. Next, P for, once again, the pain. Pain due to the polyneuropathy. We can write, or we can write the peripheral neuropathy, mononeuropathy, or we can write polyneuropathy. In a variety of, within the bracket, we should write the sensory motor neuropathy is more and more common than that of the mononeuritis multiplex. We can write. MNM means the mononeuritis multiplex. So once again, P for pain, testicular pain or tenderness, P for pain, myalgia, leg weakness or tenderness, and P for pain, once again, the polyneuropathy, mono or polyneuropathy, that can be the sensory motor neuropathy is more common than that of the mononeuritis multiplex. So the P is a bundle pack, once again the pain bundle pack, we can remember pain, testicular pain, leg tenderness, leg weakness, and once again the polyneuropathy pain means the polyneuropathy, mononeuropathy, sensory motor neuropathy than that of the mononeuritis multiplex. And P, once again, remember P ANCA positive. Within the bracket, we can write only 20% cases P ANCA positive. And then we can write the P for pressure, means the blood pressure, means the diastolic BP, we can write more than 90 millimeter of mercury. So once again, if you can consider the features of the P stands on the pain, number one, and second P stands for the P ANCA, and third P means the blood pressure, means the pressure of the diastolic blood pressure. These three bundle pack we can remember for the features of polyarteritis nodosa. So once again, number one, P for pain, we can remember the testicular pain or tenderness. Pain, once again, the leg pain, leg weakness, leg tenderness. Third P for pain, once again, pain, polyneuropathy. So this is the pain bundle pack, and second P stands on the P ANCA positivity is only 20% cases, and third P, once again, stands on the pressure. So all these P's, mean the five P's are here. We can remember. Next, the pan lost, as I said, the rule of P, once again, we can write, if we write the P, we can make it B. So it will be helpful to remember other features like B. You must remember the B stands on B for hepatitis B virus. Positive means HBsAg positive. 30% cases, or it is written anti-HBs antibody positivity. Another B for blood urea nitrogen or creatinine level is increased, unrelated to the dehydration or obstruction, it is written in your notes. And third B for biopsy, we can write the biopsy BX, alright, no problem, biopsy. So biopsy also, you must remember of the small and large vessel vasculitis, it will give you the rule of P, once again, polymorphonuclear neutrophils. Alright, so once again, the rule of P, pan lost, once again, P, make it B, B for hepatitis B virus positivity means HBsAg positive or anti-HBs antibody, and B for blood urea nitrogen positivity means the increased or the creatinine level increase. And once again, B for biopsy of the small and medium vessel vasculitis leading to the polymorphonuclear neutrophils. Along with that, AN, pan lost, as I said, AN for aneurysm. So aneurysm, we will do the arteriography. Just write it down within the bracket. Arteriography demonstrating aneurysms or occlusion of the visceral artery. So aneurysm, once again, and lost, L lost for loss of weight. Weight loss more equal 4 kgs is significant here. And L for, once again, libido reticularis. So pan lost. So once again, dear doctor, listen very carefully the features that we have studied. The five P's, three B's, and then aneurysm, one, and two L. All these features, means the 10 features are here. Among, out of 10 features, it is written that the criteria, if it is present, then the diagnosis is likely the pan. Means the 3 out of 10 criteria, according to the ACR, should be present before diagnosis the polyarteritis nodosa. So summary of the dear doctor, listen very carefully. All right, so the PAN, polyarteritis nodosa, once again the single word AN must remember, AN for aneurysm. So once again the rule of P, P for pain, pain, pain. So once again pain, that is the testicular pain or tenderness. Pain, that is the due to the muscle pain, means the leg pain, leg tenderness, leg weakness. And once again pain for the polyneuropathy. So the pain bundle, so once again P, and then after that P for Priyanka positivity, and P for pressure, means the diastolic blood pressure more than 90 millimeter of mercury. So these are the five P's that you must remember, and make the P into the B's. That is the B for HBsAg positivity, as well as the anti-HBs antibody, and B for blood urea nitrogen, and B for biopsy. And lost, PAN lost, AN for aneurysm, lost for weight loss, as well as L for libido reticularis. So all of these features are really, really important to remember all the features of PAN and making your answers correctly with confidence. So thank you very much, my dears. I hope that you enjoyed the PAN lectures along with the vasculitis. Thank you once again.